Hello student, today I am going to discuss parallelogram law of Bacteri addition. Already we have discussed triangle law of Bacteri addition in the previous video. Now second addition of Bacteri, that is parallelogram law of Bacteri addition. Now I am going to start. What is the statement of parallelogram law of Bacteri addition? It states that if two vectors acting simultaneously at a point can be represented both in magnitude and direction by the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, the resultant is represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal of the parallelogram passing through that point. Now you see the diagram. This is parallelogram. Say, AB sides represented by the vector P. P represents the AB side, and AD sides of parallelogram represent the vector Q. So P and Q are two vectors inclined to each other. The resultant of these two vectors is represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal. So AC is the diagonal. So resultant of PQ is AC, which is P plus Q, is it is denoted by R. Now we are going to calculate magnitude of R, magnitude of resultant vector R. To find the magnitude, so we have to do some construction. So that is from point C, CE is perpendicular to AB is drawn, and AB is meeting at E. AB meeting at E. Now from right angle triangle, right angled triangle AEC, AEC AEC is a right hand triangle. From Pythagoras theorem, AC square equal to AE square plus CE square. AC square equal to AE, A you can write AB plus B whole square C square. AC square, again A plus B whole square, expanded in terms of AB plus B whole square. AB square plus 2AB BE plus B square plus C square. Again you see CBE is a right angle triangle. CBE is a right angle triangle. From Pythagoras theorem, we can write CB square equal to B square plus C square. So B square plus C square, we can write CB square or BC square. So AC square equal to AB square plus 2AB B plus BC square. Now we have to find out value of B. Here let CBE equal to theta. So CBE is a right angle triangle. Since we have to find out BE, so with respect to theta, C is perpendicular and B is base. So B is base by hypotenuse. Base by hypotenuse, BC is hypotenuse, it's called cos theta. So B equal to BC cos theta. Now we are putting the value of BE here. AC square equal to AB square plus 2AB BC cos theta plus BC square. Here AB is P vector, BC is Q vector, and AC is resultant of R vector. So R square equal to P square plus 2PQ cos theta R square. So R is the resultant magnitude of resultant vector, that is P square plus Q square 2PQ cos theta. This equation number 1. Now we are going to find resultant of direction of vector. So direction, so left R vector makes angle beta with P. Left R vector makes an angle beta with P vector. This angle is beta. So we are calculating direction of resultant vector. So R vector makes angle beta with P vector. Then from right angle triangle AEC, we have same ACE. So since we are going to find the direction, so we have to tan angle. So tan of beta CE by AE. Tan of beta C by A E. Tan of beta C A, you can write again A B plus B. Already we have calculated B is BC cos theta. Now we have to calculate CE. Again, you see CE, if with respect to theta, C is perpendicular and BC hypotenuse, B is base. So C perpendicular over hypotenuse. So CE by BC equal to sine theta. So C equal to BC sin theta. BC is Q sin theta. AB is P. Tan of beta Q B will Q cos theta by P plus Q, Q sin theta by P plus Q cos theta. So this equation gives the direction of resultant vector. Now special cases. Number 1, when two vectors act in the same direction, that is theta equal to 0 degree. So from equation 1 and 2 we have R equal to root over P square plus Q square 2PQ cos of 0 degree. Cos 0 degree is 1. So we can write R equal to root over P square plus Q square 2PQ. P plus Q whole square, you can write. So R equal to P plus Q. This is the maximum resultant vector becomes maximum. And direction tan of beta q sine of 0 degree t plus q cos of 0 degree. Sine 0 degree is 0. So this is resultant 0, beta equal to 0. Resultant factor acts along the direction of the given vector. Along the direction of the given vector. Now case number 2. If theta equal to 90 degree, then from equation 1 and 2, means two vectors act perpendicular to each other. Then from equation 1 and 2 we have r equal to root over p square plus q square 2pq cos of 90 degree, cos 90 degree is 0. So it is p square plus q square. And tan of beta equal to q sine of 90 degree by p plus q cos of 90, cos 90 is 0, sin 90 is 1, so q by p. Case number 3. When two factors act in the opposite direction, then theta is 180 degree. Two factors act in the opposite direction. Then r equal to root over p square plus q square 2pq cos of 180 degree. Cos 180 degree is minus 1. R equal to root over p square plus q square plus 2pq is minus 1. That is equal to root over p square plus q square minus 2pq. R equal to p minus q whole square. So there is p minus q if p is greater than q. Also, or r equal to q minus p, if you write, then q is greater than p. And direction to find the and direction tan of beta q sine of 180 degree p plus q cos of 180 degree. Sine of 180 degree is 0, so its resultant is 0. So beta equal to 0. So beta equal to 0, it means that the given vector, the resultant vector acts along the direction of greater vector. That is, resultant vector act along the direction of greater vector. Whose vector is greater, in that direction the resultant vectors will act. Thank you.